Dear viewers, regardless of whether you are atheist, Christian, Muslim, or of any other religion in the world, at some point in your life, you have surely sought the Creator's existence. Who actually created us? Has someone created us? Or have humans evolved naturally? The answer to this question is sought by some in their religious scriptures, while others ponder upon it scientifically. Because there are more than 4,000 religions in the world, who knows which one is correct? Therefore, today we will not discuss any religious texts or religion itself. Instead, we will directly prove through scientific reasoning whether the existence of a creator is possible. If it is, then what kind of creator is it? Let's begin the video. Creator. To find the creator, you first need to go back to the beginning of creation. That means the first creation of the creator. But what is creation? How can we understand it? It is essential to know the difference between creation and the creator. Because if you don't know this distinction, then you may consider the creation as the creator and the creator as the creation. In other words, the one that has a beginning is the creation. That means its existence was not there at some point, but it exists now, and that is creation. So, who is the creator? The one that has no beginning and no end is the creator. It means the one that always existed, beyond time, controlling time, for whom there is no past, present, and future. Everything is the same for that entity, and that is the creator. Now let's go back to the beginning of creation. When we go back to the Big Bang theory, according to this theory, everything in the universe was once a tiny particle, a singularity. Then, due to an explosion, the Big Bang occurred and the creation of the universe took place. That means science believes the universe started from a single particle that always existed. It did not have a birth because nothing can be created from nothing. If the beginning of the universe was not from a singularity but from nothingness, then everything in the universe would have emerged from nothing. Therefore, according to science, creation has happened from the creator itself. And from a scientific perspective, the creator is only one. Now, you think for yourself and compare it with other religions. Which religions consider the creator as one? Even though we have religious scriptures, we still have doubts. If the creator exists, why can't we see them? Some practical examples can be given to address this question. We, as humans, are the creators of the devices like the mobile phone or computer you are using to watch this video. But does the device know its creator? Who is the creator of this computer or mobile? The machine doesn't know it because it lacks consciousness or intellect. Despite being so close to it, the machine doesn't know that we are its creators. It lacks the ability to perceive or see. Similarly, we, as humans, possess various capabilities such as the power of hearing, seeing, and experiencing. To know the creator, we need additional abilities beyond what machines possess. Now, let's consider another scenario. Suppose this machine could possess artificial intelligence created by humans, but it still couldn't see or experience. In that case, the machine might claim, "I don't have a creator," even though we are the ones who have it in our hands. Due to its lack of experiential capacity and absence of vision, it fails to comprehend or observe. Indeed, we, as humans, have limitations in our abilities. Humans possess many abilities, including the power of hearing, seeing, and experiencing. To understand the creator, we would require a higher level of intelligence. Only then can we find the creator. So, I hope you have understood the concept of the creator through this video today. If you want more rational videos on religion, please subscribe to this channel. Thank you.